They need to stay here. And he spoke to the captain and the centurion and told them what God had told them. He said, no, this place is not a good place to stay. It's not a good place to winter in. And winter's coming. And I like what it says. As a gentle breeze began to blow, they cut loose from the island, set their course to go by creek. It says, on their way, all of a sudden, tempestuous, I'll get it out in a minute, wind arose called the Arachlodon. In our terms, we call that a hurricane. Now, I'll tell you, there's a lot of forces in nature that can affect this world in a great way, but none as powerful as a hurricane affecting as far as it does. Earthquakes affect the local area. Volcanic explosions can disrupt things. But man, hurricanes seem to have a powerful effect on everything. The ocean, the land, the people, the inhabitants, and even the weather after that. What an awesome force they were fighting. Something more powerful than any man could ever think to control. And this force started taking that little old ship, tossing it about from wave to wave. Men began to fear for their life, thinking they were going to die. They started throwing off the tackle of the ship because they said, what good is the tackle going to do if you're going to die? And little by little, they cut everything off that ship and they took ropes and wrapped around the ship all the way around and tied them as tight as they could, winched them as tight as possible to try to hold the wood and the structure of the ship together. But to no avail, the wind blew for days and days and days. They didn't see the sun. They didn't see the stars. You know, you may be in a situation where you hadn't seen any light for a long time. Things have been going on in your life, and it just keeps going on. It's like, will there ever be any daylight in my life? Was there ever any hope of this storm ever stopping for me? Where is it going to end? The Word of God says that Paul spoke to him. He said, hey, angel appeared unto me. He said, there's not going to be a loss of a life here if you'll just stay with the ship.
Right.
Praise God.
Folks, that's some good news.
That's right.
Yeah.
If you just stay with Jesus Christ, if you'll just stay on board with Him, it's all going to be all right. It might be a little rough. It might get a little windy. It might get a little uncertain. But I can tell you right now, if Jesus Christ is with you and you're with Him, it's going to work out. Amen. Yes. Stay on board the ship. Don't abandon the boat because He's going to take you where you're supposed to go.
Yes.
Let's go back to Daniel. Daniel, the third chapter. All of a sudden, the king invites Daniel. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego says, step out of the fire. Come out here where I am. Verse 24 says, then King Nebuchadnezzar was astonished, and he rose in haste and spoke, saying to his counselors, did we not cast three men into the fire in the midst of the fire? And they answered and said, O king, true. He says, look, he answered, I see four loose and walking in the midst of the fire, and they are not hurt. And the fourth is like the form of the Son of God. Amen. Verse 27 says, and the satraps, administrators, governors, and the king's counselors gathered together, and they saw that these men on whose bodies the fire had no power. Pay attention, underline that in your Bible. Whose bodies the fire had no power, the hair of their head was not singed, nor were their garments affected, and the smell of smoke was not even on. Praise the Lord. That's the kind of God I serve. Amen. You can come through the fire and not even smell like smoke. Yeah. Amen. It says, Nebuchadnezzar spoke, saying, bless the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who sent His angel, underline that, that's Jesus Christ, by the way, if you're looking, searching and looking for who He is, there it is, His angel, and delivered His servants who trusted in Him, and they have frustrated the king's word and yielded their bodies, and that they should not serve nor worship any god except their own God. God of God, God the creator of all things of heaven and earth, the creator of you. Amen. He goes goes on and says, therefore I make a decree that any people, nation, or tongue, or language that speaks anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be cut in pieces, and their houses shall be made an ash heap, because there is no other God who can deliver like this. Can I tell you something, church? There's no God that can deliver you like my God.
Amen.
There's no God that can deliver you like the Creator of all things. Amen. There's no God that can set you free and deliver you like the King of Kings.
Amen.
And the Lord of Lords. Can I tell you this morning, that man that walked in the midst of fire is here with you in your circumstances. The man who walked in the midst of the fire, who caused the fire not to harm their bodies, is right there with you in your sickness and your pain. Amen.
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 Yes, right, God. That's right.
You see, not only was he there to deliver them, but because, listen to this now, because of their faithfulness, because they would not compromise, it changed the law of the land.
Amen.
You see where I'm going with this? If God's people, who are called by his name, will humble themselves and pray. There's the key, folks.
Yes.
Humble yourself and pray. He said, then I will hear from heaven and heal the land. Can I tell you? We live in a land that's got a blight and a curse on it.
Amen.
If you go back and you study Leviticus, God said if the people, his people, which was to turn from his word, he said that the land would vomit out its inhabitants, it would throw them up.
Mm-hmm.
You know that's what's happening to America?
Amen.
Yes.
A lot of America has turned away from God.
Yeah.
And because of that, the land is vomiting us out. I know that sounds gross, but it's the truth.
Truth.
But if my people, let me tell you, he's always got a people.
Yeah.
He's got a people that will not compromise.
That's right.
They will not change their mind about God.
Amen.
They're going to serve him despite what the rulers do. They're going to serve him despite what the neighbors do. They're going to serve him despite what somebody who's a non-believer says.
Amen.
They're going to serve him anyway.
Mm-hmm.
If you'll be faithful to that, God can change the very laws of the land you live in.
Yeah.
Yes.
He can affect your king because he'll show up in the midst of your fire. Amen. Going back to Matthew. Go back to Matthew. The 8th chapter. If you look back there in Matthew 8, 8th chapter, verse 28. He said, and when he was come to the other side, into the country of the Gerasenes, there met him two possessed with devils coming out of the tombs, exceedingly fierce, so that no man might pass on by that way. You see, Jesus had a specific appointment at the other side.
Amen.
When he told them to get into the boat and go to the other side, he knew exactly where he was to land. Now the storm came in between the time he said go to the other side and the time he reached Gennesaret. Those men, I believe, when they set course, may have looked at the wrong place and been heading the wrong way. It's possible.